eGaN FETs and integrated circuits have been in production at efficient power conversion for over 10 years. We launched these products with the goal of being higher performance and lower cost than the aging silicon MOSFET. We are changing the game. Let's discuss how. When our costs fell below the cost of MOSFETs about 3 years ago, we decided to mount a frontal assault on silicon MOSFETs where the input or output voltages are in the range of 48 volts. 48-volt input requires 80 to 100-volt devices, and 48-volt outputs require 100 to 200-volt devices. eGaN FETs are clearly smaller, more efficient, and competitively priced in that range of voltages. As an example where the big shift is happening, let's look at the traditional server architecture shown here, which uses rack-based 48-volt isolated and regulated DC to DC converters that convert to 12 volts. Then a 12-volt to point-of-load converter to the GPU or CPU. Due to the increasing power of the new generation of GPU-based AI servers, they're migrating from 12 volts input to 48-volt input on the server board. Let's see what that would look like. Here we see this new topology where the input of the server board is 48 volts. The most efficient way to convert power from 48 volts to point of load is a two-stage conversion with intermediate voltage of 5 volts that allows you to take advantage of the latest BCDMOS technology for both the secondary stage of the 48 to 5 volt converter and the point of load converter from 5 volts down to 0.6 volts. The evolution from 12 volt to 48 volts with a 5 volt bus reduces energy losses by over 30%. By the way, take a look at this picture. There are no silicon MOSFETs. Mild hybrid cars are also converting to 48-volt distribution bus architecture. By 2025, it's projected that over 11 million cars will have 48-volt buses with power ranging from 1 to 4 kilowatts. In this 3-kilowatt example of a multi-phase buck converter, due to fast switching speed, GaN-based solutions can operate efficiently at 250 kHz per phase, as opposed to 125 kHz per phase for traditional MOSFETs, resulting in the reduction from a 5-phase MOSFET system to a 4-phase GaN system. As seen here, the GaN-based solution is 35% smaller and 20% less expensive to build. And now EPC is creating even greater distance between MOSFETs and eGaN devices. In March 2020, EPC launched the ePower stage, EPC 2152, shown here. It's a monolithic power stage, including 80-volt power FETs in a half bridge, drivers, level shift, synchronous bootstrap circuit, and input logic. This 3 megahertz power stage is a logic in and power out device whose performance is far superior to even discrete GaN transistors. It is the dawn of a new age of power GaN ICs. For more information, visit us at epc-co.com or stop by our virtual booth during PCIM Digital Days.